The door to learning.
The door to learning.
Jesus Christ, the door.
Jesus Christ, the door.
Amen. My name is Grant, and I have the distinct privilege and honor of teaching you the Baptist World Alliance Congress theme song for 2015. So I'm going to invite you to stand and join us as we sing the song, Jesus is the Door. Jesus is the door, He's the only way. In Him we have life, through Him we are saved. Let's hear you try it. Jesus is the door, He's the only way. In Him we have life, through Him we are saved. Let's sing it again. Jesus is the door.
Jesus is the door. He's the only way. In Him we have life. Through Him we are saved.
Now listen, light of the world.
Light. Light of the world.
Eternal life. Now you try it. Light of the world.
Light. Light of the world. Eternal. Eternal life.
Let's sing it again. Light of the world. Liberty.
Through the door we find liberty, leadership, love, and so much more. There's salvation, security, but only through the door.
One more time, through the door.
Through the door we find liberty, leadership, love, and so much more. There's salvation, security, but only.
That was very well done. So I'm going to ask us to try all of that again. But this time, you can move if you want, because that's how we do it here in Africa. And you can clap your hands. Are you ready? Are you ready? Jesus is the door.
Jesus is the door. He's the only way. In Him we have life. Through Him we are saved.
Light of the world.
Light of the world.
can feel free to take a seat just as we wait. We've got 5 more minutes until the session officially starts.
The living water. Oh, I'm out. tended and treasured by the pure in heart, shadowed and shunned by the deceitful, peerless and pierced, we exalt you. From the rising of the sun till its setting in the west, God's holy name be praised. On the lips of children, by babies at the breast, God's holy name be praised. In the visions of the old and the dreaming of the young, God's holy name be praised. In the banquet hall of heaven and the forgotten corners of our hearts, God's holy name be praised. Let all that has life and breath praise the Lord.
Amen.
We praise the Lord.
Should we all stand together as we sing this first song of worship?
Say that you're my God.
sisters and brothers, the Baptists of South Africa, come now to welcome us.
Sanbonani, Dumelem, Molweni, Goeienaand. Welcome to the presentation of the South African presentation. We prepared later during the program we will be singing the national anthem. If you would like to sing along, a bookmark with the anthem has been provided in your bag. Shall we pray? Father, we just thank you for this opportunity that we can come and share and rejoice, sharing our common faith together as Baptists in South Africa this evening. We ask that you would accept our praises as an offering and honor to your name. We just ask that you'll be with us now. In Jesus' name, amen.
John chapter 10, verse 7. Therefore Jesus said again, I tell you the truth, I am the door for the sheep. On behalf of our fellow African brothers and sisters, we want to welcome you to the tip of Africa, to the Rainbow Nation of South Africa.
When I was to be said, you gave me. Zulu la vulega, kabona umbono.
Umbono kate, opa.
Zulu la vulega, kase ngabona umbono wakhe.
Umbono kate, opa.
Zulu la vulega, amasage zula vuliwe lena.
Let us tell you about the Rainbow Nation since the new democratic country came into being. During the brief existence of our young nation, we have many highlights that we can celebrate. South Africa, like many other African countries, was colonized. During the early 1990s, F.W. de Klerk took a bold step and introduced changes that led to the unbanning of political organizations. And transformation started taking place. The release of Nelson Mandela and other political prisoners from Robben Island. The negotiations and the violence and how the country avoided civil war. The first democratic election after a negotiated transition, how God used leadership, both black and white, to unify our country as all people went to the first democratic elections in South Africa. A country in transition. Right, winning the Rugby World Cup in 1995 and in 2007. Winning the Africa Cup of Nations in 1996. Hosting the 2010 Soccer World Cup. South African in space, Mark Shuttleworth. Nobel Prize winners, Nelson Mandela, F.W. de Klerk, Desmond Tutu. Radio telescope technology and the Gautrain. Baptists, however, have a much longer history in our country, which began in 1820 with the first British settlers to our beautiful country. Among those settlers were 11 Baptist believers, and soon they formed an informal fellowship under William Miller. He was not an ordained minister, but with an evangelical passion, he assumed the role of pastor and held weekly services under an acacia thorn tree on the African bushveld in front of his tent. In the 1860s, thousands of Germans settled in the Eastern Cape, and the Reverend Hugo Gucci was sent from Germany to establish a Baptist ministry among them. German and English Baptists formed the Baptist Union of Southern Africa in 1877. And in 1886, Pastor J.D. Oudendaal established the first Afrikaans Baptist Church. In 1869, the first mission to the Xhosa people was initiated, and the Chaba Mission near King Williamstown was established by Karl Pape, a German farmer. Some years later, the first African evangelist John Adams was appointed to lead the mission. Between 1860 and 1910, more than 150,000 Indian immigrants came to South Africa to meet the labor shortage in KwaZulu-Natal. In 1903, the Reverend John Rangia was sent from India to establish a Baptist work among them. It was also during those years when Pastor Valpolo Jacob and his son built up the Indian Baptist Mission, planting many churches. By the early 1900s, the Cape Town Baptist Church was well established, and as a mother church had planted other English churches around the fringes of Cape Town, Mowbray, Claremont, and Wynberg. But then God gave these churches the vision to reach out to the vast and fast-developing colored areas across the Cape Flats. Mission churches were soon planted in Shepherd Street, District 6, Athlone, Batswood, Wynberg, and Gleemore. In 1955, 30 students from the Kung Ting Chinese School in Johannesburg met for Bible study, and one day 16 of these students made a commitment. These teenagers formed the foundation members of the Chinese Church in South Africa. They joined another group of Chinese believers from Ferreristown to form the Chinese Baptist Church, and the Reverend Arthur Song was later appointed as their minister, and he faithfully pastored them for many years. The first Portuguese work was established in 1960 with the influx of Portuguese immigrants into South Africa from Angola and from Mozambique through the influence of a certain Mr. Imri in Johannesburg. The work soon grew, and Pastor Almeida was appointed as their minister. A few years later, Pastor Geronimo took over the reins, constituting the first Baptist Church of Johannesburg. During the 1980s, as apartheid was being dismantled, a change of thinking on this issue took place, and steps were taken to integrate all Baptist church groups into one association, in keeping with the biblical principles of unity and equality in Christ. However, the 1880s was also a period of great political and racial tension, and the Baptist Convention decided to remain an independent convention. During the 1990s, Baptists in South Africa joined together to form South African Baptist Alliance, and there remains today a relationship of mutual cooperation, as our common purpose remains the extension of God's kingdom. From humble beginnings in 1820, the Baptists in South Africa grew from 11 settlers to more than 100,000 members by the year 2000, spreading over more than 600 congregations. It is no longer a predominantly English-speaking white church. but now is fully and completely representative of our diverse population, the Rainbow Nation. Our vision remains the same that we received from Jesus Christ, the head of the church: go and make disciples. And as we have celebrated these achievements of our young nation and our varied Baptist roots, we cannot end without making mention of the father of South Africa, who led our country to become a real and true democracy and who helped to establish our Rainbow Nation. Will the congregation please stand for the singing of the South African National Anthem?
Mano padani.
I would like to invite the MEC for Economic Development, Tourism, Environmental Affairs, the Honorable Mr. Michael Mabuya-Kulu of the KwaZulu-Natal province to the podium.
Thank you very much, program directors, for introducing us. The Reverend John Upton, the President of the Baptist Wild Alliance, the Reverend David Coffey, the immediate past president, the Reverend Paul Msiza, the president-elect, the Reverend Neville Callum, the General Secretary of the Baptist Wild Alliance, the Vice President present, Mr. James Simo, the CEO of the KwaZulu-Natal Durban Conventions Bureau, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and all protocol observed. On behalf of the KwaZulu-Natal Provincial Government and His Excellency, the Premier of this province, the Honorable Senzo Mchunu, we wish to convey our gratitude to the organizers of this auspicious occasion for choosing the city of Durban for your Congress. This is a demonstration that our province and our country, more particularly our continent, is becoming the world's preferred venue for high-profile gatherings, an expression of confidence in the quality of service of the city that we can offer to the international community. We are indeed thankful to this positive development and are therefore hopeful that the congregants and other visitors gracing this historic function that is coming to Africa for the first time would enjoy their stay in this beautiful city. We also want to take this opportunity to say to you that as a country, as a province, as we have seen in the video that has been presented here, we are a free nation, a country where each and every citizen is allowed to practice his or her faith without fear of reprisal from any organs of the state. The modern faith centers, besides being homes for spirituality and healing services, they are also crucial contributors to economic development in various ways. Hence, we want to say to you, as you enjoy your stay here in KwaZulu-Natal, we want you to be hard at work, but we also want you to find time between the various meetings to be able to explore what this city and this province can offer. For those who are coming outside of our shores, it is important for me, as responsible for the economy and tourism in this province, to indicate to you that we have got wonderful shopping malls, and to indicate to you that indeed we will look after your euros and your dollars and your pounds, and that when you come during this time, you couldn't have come at a better time, when indeed in terms of the rand, dollar or euro exchange rate, it is so good that you would like to live here permanently. I therefore want to take this opportunity to say to you that we want to welcome you here and know that we are a good people. You will feel the warmth and the love of our people. And above all, you will be able to worship God without any fear of any kind. for we are a nation that fears God. We also want to thank you for coming with the showers of blessings. This province has experienced drought for the last 3 years. And the mere fact that you are hosting this Congress here, indeed we see the rains. So as I conclude, ladies and gentlemen, allow me once again to say to you, we have very fascinating and interesting sites that you can visit, that you can see. During this time in South Africa, it is winter time. And because we are in the eastern seaboard of South Africa, we only know two seasons here in this part of South Africa. It is summer and forever summer. I want therefore to invite you to enjoy the wonderful Indian Ocean, to enjoy the unspoiled beaches that we have, to enjoy Ushaka Marine, to enjoy the Inanda Heritage Route, where we have Mahatma Gandhi and many other prominent leaders, including where President Nelson Mandela voted for the first time in 1994. All of that it is in this very beautiful city of Durban. Welcome to Durban, welcome to KwaZulu-Natal, welcome to South Africa, welcome to the African continent. Enjoy yourselves.
To our Honorable MEC. Mr. Michael Mabuyakulu, we as the Baptist family in South Africa, in the world, want to say thank you for the kind words of welcome. We want to say thank you that you've received us in this province, that you've received us in this beautiful country of South Africa. We receive those greetings and want to say thank you and convey our wishes and our prayers for the province to our Honorable Premier, Mr. Senzo Mkhunu. My dear sisters and brothers, to our President, John Upton, our General Secretary, Dr. Neville Callum, our past President, Dr. David Coffey, to all the Vice President who are present in this house, I stand here on behalf of the Local Arrangements Committee to welcome you to this 21st World Congress of the Baptist World Alliance. We stand as a Baptist body together from the Baptist Association, the Baptist Convention of South Africa, the Baptist Mission of South Africa, the Baptist Union of South Africa, to say to you, welcome to our lovely country. Welcome to South Africa. Welcome to this beautiful place that God has given to us. Yes, welcome to the country of AmaZulu, AmaXhosa, AmaSwati, AbeSuthu, AmaShangani, Abetswana, Mapedi, Amangisi, Amandiya, Amafrikanisi, Amakhoi, Namasen, Amavenda, kunye namaNdebele. We are all the people of the Rainbow Nation. The Baptist, if I would use the language you use down here, the Baptist of Umzansi, welcome you, and we pray that your stay here will be a one of celebration and joy. We welcome you and trust that you're going to enjoy yourself, enjoy the African culture, the South African culture of Ubuntu, enjoy our music starting from Isicathamiya to Mbaqanga to Bure music and to African jazz. We just want to welcome you and say feel at home. And we want just to say in conclusion that to all present here, you need to know that not only did the MEC welcome us to the province on behalf of the Premier, but our province has made more than that. They took a step to ensure that they contribute to us the hosting of this conference. And with those words, I want to say thank you, sir. God bless you all. May the Lord bless you. Enjoy South Africa. Amen.
Like the rainbow nation of South Africa, Baptist Christians from all over the world have gathered here to celebrate in this 21st Baptist World Congress. Amongst us from all around the world are the following countries:
Angola, Argentina, Australia, Austria, Bahamas,
Bangladesh, Benin, Botswana, Brazil, Bulgaria,
Burundi, Cameroon, Canada, Central African Republic, Chad,
Chile, Colombia, Democratic Republic of Congo, Costa Rica, Croatia,
Denmark, Dominican Republic, Ecuador, Egypt, Estonia,
Ethiopia, Finland, France, Germany, Ghana,
Guatemala. Guyana. Haiti. Hong Kong. Hungary.
India. Indonesia. Israel. Italy. Jamaica.
Japan. Kenya. Korea. Lebanon. Liberia.
Yes. Madagascar. Malawi. Malaysia. Mozambique. Namibia.
Nepal. The Netherlands. New Zealand. Nigeria. Norway.
Panama. Papua New Guinea. Philippines. Poland. Romania.
The Russian Federation. Rwanda. Serbia. Singapore. South Sudan.
Spain. Sri Lanka. Sweden. Switzerland. The United Republic of Tanzania.
Togo. Trinidad and Tobago. Turkey. Turks and Caicos Islands. Uganda. Ukraine.
The United Kingdom. United States of America. Venezuela. Zambia. Zimbabwe. And the Republic of South Africa.
In July of 2010, we had 5,332 persons from 105 nations around the world that gathered together in Honolulu, Hawaii for the 20th Congress of the Baptist World Alliance.
Today, in Durban, South Africa, the 21st Baptist World Alliance Congress begins.
In 2010, in the land of Aloha, we met under the theme of Hear the Spirit.
Today, in the land of Ubuntu, our theme is Jesus Christ the Door.
We want to thank South African Baptists for hosting us in their beautiful country, and also for the warm welcome that they've extended to us.
On behalf of the Baptist World Alliance, I am pleased to welcome you all to this, the 21st Baptist World Alliance Congress. And we gather in the name of our Lord, and to all who are shut out, to all who are trapped in, hear this good news. Jesus Christ is the door. Let us rejoice. And let us celebrate. Amen.
Thank you. God of eternity, when the voice of the prophet was silent and the face of your people, Lord, when darkness had obscured light and indifferent display sealed, you saw that the time was right and prepared to send your son, set us free from faithlessness, that we made be ready always to welcome him who comes as Savior and Lord.
Eternal God, creator of all, savior of all, Lord of all, your love and power encompass all things and all people. There is no one beyond the reach of your redeeming love. We thank you that in all countries there are witnesses to your gospel, bearing testimony through their words and actions to the good news of Jesus Christ.
We thank you for your church in each place, for your spirit, equipping it with gifts and empowering your people to proclaim the good news of Jesus Christ. We thank you for Christian partnerships across continents and national borders, for those we have responded to your call to serve the church in a land that is not their own. Grant that we may be worthy of the great company of saints, ready to witness and serve in the name of Jesus Christ, the life of the world.
I invite you to stand with me as we prepare to raise our voices to God in prayer. We pray to God who has created the energy of youth and in grace gives wisdom to the aged and gives strength to all. Let us pray in the words that the Lord Jesus taught us as we have spoken of it as the Lord's Prayer. And I invite you to join me as each of us pray in our heart language. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Our Bible reading is from the book of Isaiah, chapter 60, and I will read in Arabic. قومي استنيري لأنه قد جاء نورك ومجد الرب أشرق عليك لأنه ها هي الظلمة تغطي الأرض والظلام الدامس الأمم أما عليك فيشرق الرب ومجده عليك يرى فتسير الأمم في نورك والملوك في ضياء إشراقه ارفعي عينيك حواليك وانظري قد اجتمعوا كلهم جاءوا إليك يأتي بنوك من بعيد وتحمل بناتك على الأيدي The word of God, thanks be to God.
John chapter 1, verse 1 to 9. I'm reading in Telugu, one of the languages in India. Adiyandu vakyamundenu, vakyamu devuni yaddu undenu, vakyamu devudai undenu, ayana adiyandu devuni yaddu undenu, samastamu ayana moolamuga kaliginu, kaligina dediyu ayana lekunda kalagaledu, ayana lo jeevamundenu, aa jeevamu manushulaku velugai undenu. ఆ వెలుగు చీకటిలో ప్రకాశించుచున్నది గాని చీకటి దాన్ని గ్రహింపకుండెను దేవుని యొద్ద నుండి పంపబడిన ఒక మనుష్యుడు ఉండెను అతని పేరు యోహాను అతని మూలముగా అందరూ విశ్వసించినట్లు అతడు ఆ వెలుగును గూర్చి సాక్ష్యమిచ్చుటకు సాక్షిగా వచ్చెను అతడు ఆ వెలుగై ఉండలేదు కానీ ఆ వెలుగును గూర్చి సాక్ష్యమిచ్చుటకు అతడు వచ్చెను నిజమైన వెలుగు ఉండెను అది లోకమునకు వచ్చుచు ప్రతి మనిషిని వెలిగించుచున్నది ద వర్డ్ ఆఫ్ ద లార్డ్ థ్యాంక్స్ బి టు గాడ్
Going to read from John chapter 1, verse 1 through 9 with Amharic. Bamajemmeria, Kalnebre, Kalem Bexavier than Nebre, Kalem Xavier Nebre. Ye Bamajemmeria, Bexavier than Nebre, Uluber Sohona, Conom Andash and Quayal Swalhona. Bersi Hot Nebrech, Hotem Yesobran Nebrech. Branam Bachalama Yabaral, Chalamam Alashanafo Kaxiabir Yetalakasumu Yohannethemibal and the Sona Berre Huluber Subakul in Diamanuik Celebran, Ymasakarzand, Lemasakermata Celebran Limasakermatanji, Irsubran Al Nabaram Lesa Hulu Miabaro, Unatan Yabran, Wedalem, Ymatanaber. Amen.
Should we stand together as we prepare to sing this next song?
The Holy Spirit gives gifts to be used to build up the body of Christ. And among those are the gifts of preaching and teaching. Tonight we welcome our brother, the Reverend Dr. Peter Chin, who will bring us a message from God concerning Jesus Christ the door to light. Dr. Chin is senior pastor of the Global Mission Church in Bundang Sunji District in South Korea. Let us pray. Lord God, by your Holy Spirit, anoint our brother's lips and our ears so that he may speak and we may receive your message to us tonight. Through Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen.
It's great to be here with you today. How about we greet one another by saying, "You look beautiful today." How about you respond to them by saying, "It's because your eyes are beautiful." It's great to be here. We are marching in the light of God. Amen. It's the first time we are meeting here in Africa. And I served in Kenya for about 3 years as a missionary. So Africa is so close to my heart. And where we are here for our Baptist World Alliance, we are so thankful that we can have this meeting in the soil of Africa for the glory of God. I remember a particular day that I was serving in Africa, Kenya. I was invited to speak in a church, a little bit countryside, and it was Wednesday night service. Here I was preaching, and in the middle of sermon, just power just went out. And here I was preaching, and suddenly I could not see anything. And, you know, I've been in the darkness before, but at that night, it was so dark, I could not see a thing. It was pitch darkness, and I wasn't even sure whether I was open my eyes or closed. I'm sure I opened my eyes, but I couldn't see anything. I was keep checking. I must close my eyes, but I could not see a thing at that night. So I was so panicking. I didn't know what to do and wait until someone brought a candle light. And suddenly, it was flickering light, but yet the light came in and it drove out the darkness and we began to see things. And I remember this time, whenever we look into the passage we just read, the Bible says in John chapter 8, verse 12, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in the darkness and will have a light of life." This is what Jesus said, "I am the light of the world." What does he mean when he says, "I am the light of the world"? The first of all, that Jesus is the light that shines in darkness. In chapter 8 of John, we see the incident taking place. The woman is caught in action in adultery. And the Pharisees and the teachers of law brought her at the knee of Jesus and trying to condemn her and testing Jesus how he's going to respond to that. And Jesus said to them, "If any one of you who has no sin, be the first one to stone her." And from the oldest to the youngest, one by one, everyone left. And only Jesus and the woman was left. And Jesus said to her, "Where is anyone who's condemning you?" And she said, "No one." And Jesus said, "Neither I condemn you. Go and sin no more." And then right after that, in verse 12, that Jesus said, "I am the light of the world." You see, Jesus saw what's inside a man's heart. Even though they're Pharisees and the teachers of the law, even though they came to condemn her, they had no light in their heart. Jesus saw the darkness. And there Jesus said, I am the light of the world, that whoever follows me will never walk in the darkness. You see, we're living in the world filled with the darkness. There's so much darkness around us. There's a darkness of heart that is so blinded by all the deceptions and lies. The darkness of life, the people aging and suffering and dying. We have political darkness, corruptions, bribery. We have economic darkness, poverty, debts, greed. We have spiritual darkness. People say there's no God. They could not see the light. Yet Jesus says, I am the light. And when light comes, it drives out all the darkness. And I am the light of the world, that Jesus says. You see, the light brings life. The light brings resurrection. The light brings forgiveness. The light brings power of God. And Jesus says, I am the light of the world. He shines in darkness. Secondly, the Bible tells us that Jesus is a light that shines for life. He says, whoever follows me will never walk in the darkness, but will have a light of life. You see, in John chapter 7, from this text we know, it was time of Feast of Tabernacle. It was a ceremony where the people were gathered together to remember how God led Israelites, their ancestor, in the wilderness for 40 years. The Bible says God led them by the pillar of clouds and by the pillar of fire. They showed the path of their ways to all the way to the land of Canaan. And people remember those things, and they put these four big gold candles and light it. And all writings tells us from all over from Jerusalem, they will see the light because that flame was so bright. And they will all remember how God led their people in the wilderness with the pillar of the fire that lighted their path. And then we see chapter 8. Maybe by that time, it was the end of the Feast of Tabernacle. Big golden candle light is slowly fading away and dying out. In that very moment, the Bible says that Jesus said, I am the light of the world. You see, it was dying and fading away, the candle light. Yet Jesus says, I am the light. It is inextinguishable, true light, everlasting light. And I am the light of the world, that Jesus said. And we know from Greek text, it's called great I am statement. Ego emi, I am that I am. In from Old Testament, God says, I am that I am. In the very statement that Jesus saying and claiming that I am God, I am the light, I am the light of the world. And Jesus is the light that shines for life, that will have light of life. You see, we were in darkness. The Bible tells us in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 8, once we were darkness, yet Jesus came and we became light in the Lord. All of us were in the darkness, and Jesus came and lighted in our lives. And we have a life. That's how Jesus came down on earth. He gave his life on the cross for you and me. And he died on the cross so that he may give life in us. I remember a story that I just read from the internet. It was a story about little Johnny, second grade in elementary school. The little Johnny's teacher called his mom to talk with him. And the teacher was trying to explain to the Johnny's mom, "Last week, we had a class, and I explained to my kids about the story about the grasshopper and ant. There was grasshopper and ant, and the ant was working so hard gathering food for the winter. But grasshopper did not gather anything, and he was kept on playing. And the teacher said, the winter came, what would happen? They have to finish up the story and turn it in as assignment. Following week, teacher gathered all their assignments and read through. And she said to Johnny's mom, you know, as I was reading through, there were two groups of kids. One group of kids saying, you know, grasshopper didn't have anything to eat, and the ant has a lot of food, so ant lived and grasshopper died. The other group of kids said, you know, ant was so nice, and in fact, he shared his food with grasshopper, then they lived together, happily ever after. But it was a little Johnny who brought an assignment that was so different than anything else. And that's the very reason the teacher called John's mom. And teacher explained, you know, little Johnny brought an assignment, and he said, ant gave all his food to grasshopper, and he died. And then by the end, the little Johnny brought little cross. You know, when I was reading that story, I laughed because I was thinking, you know, what kind of ant would that be? It's dumb ant. It's so stupid. Doesn't make sense. There's no ant like that. And then I remember from the scripture how God, who was Jesus, equality with God and given up the privilege of heaven, came down and became one of us. He emptied himself and died on the cross. Jesus shines for life, and we have life. And that's what famous John Newton, who used to sell the slaves, came to know Christ. And he sang, amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I was a blind, but now I see. I was lost and am found. When John Newton, at the end of his life, he said, you know, I'm so old now, I cannot remember many things. In fact, I can't even remember my children's name. But there's two things I remember clearly. One, I am a great sinner. Two, that Jesus Christ is even greater Savior. Jesus shines for life. We have that life. Third, the Bible tells us that Jesus is the light that shines on you. We reflect the light of Jesus. In Matthew chapter 5:14, that Jesus said, you are the light of the world. It's not he said, I'm the light of the world. He also said to us that you are the light of the world. Who, me, Lord? Yes, you. How can I be the light of the world? And Jesus said, you have me in you. I am the light. I shine on you. You are the light of the world. And we shine on. The Bible tells us in Ephesians chapter 5:8 that we are the children of the light. The fruit of light is goodness and righteousness and truth. We bear those fruits and shine on because Jesus shines on you. And Isaiah 60 says, arise and shine. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord rises on you. And we ask, where should we light and shine on? In Matthew chapter 5 tells us that the lamp should not be hidden under the bowl. It has to stand out, show the light. You see, we have Jesus' light in us, and we cannot help but shining on because He's the light in us. And the Bible tells us it should not be under or hidden, yet stand out. Then we ask, where should we put our lamp? Clear answer, where there is darkness. Where there is darkness in our countries, where there is a darkness in our homes, in our workplace, even in our churches. We shine because Jesus is the light, shines on us. Little children, they come together and play in a playground in the game of pretend. They're taking turns, and each one of them tell what they want to be. One kid says, I want to be a king. And he start acting like a king and talk like a king. And others will bow down, oh, your great highness, yes, your majesty. And he's enjoying being a king. And then, next was a little girl's turn. Kids asked, so what do you want to be? She thought about a minute, and she ran and stand against the wall. And she said, I want to be sunshine. And then little kids all came toward her and stood nearby her. And they start talking. Oh, you're so bright. Oh, it's nice. Oh, it's so warm. That's right. Sunshine. That's who we are. Jesus is the light. He shines on us. We are the light. We shine on. You see, we Baptists are known as people of the book. Now let us be known as people of the light. For Jesus is the light. And brothers and sisters, we shine on. You shine on. For Jesus is the light of the world. Amen? Let's pray. Dear Lord, that is our prayer, that we may become your light that shines on in anywhere and everywhere there's a darkness, because you shine on us, O God. We have you in us, for you are the light of the world. So wherever we go, O God, may your light shine on them so that there will be a life, there will be a resurrection, for there will be a love and peace, righteousness. Father, we pray that you call us upon so that we may become the children of the light, that this world will be brightened because our light's radiance, it shines for this world. So that people will know that you are the light indeed, O God. We thank you for being our light. May we live a light right to be the light for your kingdom and for your glory. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
The Lord God has been speaking to us tonight through our brother. Each of us hear that word and it touches different parts of our lives. I invite us now to a moment of continued inviting of the Spirit of God to do God's work in us. How did the Spirit speak? What did you hear? What made you uncomfortable? What brought you peace? In these moments, I invite you to lift your heart to God. I invite you to bring to God in silent prayer thanks for those things that bring peace, thanks for those things that have been uncomfortable, thanks for the ways that the Word of God has shined light even on darkness within us. In these moments of silent prayer, let us bring our words to God. Lord God, we thank you for your promise that the work that you have begun in us, you will bring to completion. Help us more and more to open ourselves, our hearts, our minds, our lives, our actions, our relationships to you, that your will may be done in and through us. And that you, not we, will receive the praise and the glory. For we pray in your holy name, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Should we stand as we close with this last song?
Yeah. us pray. God of light, God of darkness. In the darkness, we see the splendor of the universe, blankets of stars, the solitary glowing of distant planets. Your darkness allowed Magi to find the star that guided them to the place where the Christ child lay. We thank you. God of light, God of darkness, in blessed desert darkness, Mary and Joseph were able to flee with the infant Jesus to safety in Egypt. We thank you. God of light, God of darkness, in the darkness of night, desert people find relief from the cruel, relentless heat of the sun. We thank you. God of light, God of darkness, in the darkness of sleep, we are soothed and restored, healed and renewed. In the darkness of sleep, dreams rise up. You speak to us, and we find answers that we need. We thank you. In the darkness and in the light, continue, gracious God, to make yourself known to us and give us cause to rejoice. We pray in the name of Christ our Savior. Amen. And now receive the benediction. May the Father of life pour out grace upon us. May we feel God's hand in everything we do and be strengthened by the challenges God brings us through. And may the blessing of the radiant God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Good night, and God bless you all.